Oh. Patricia Ann Mackey woke up trying to open the door of the car, but passed out again. She woke up again, and she was in the hospital. When she woke up, she seen nurses and physicians surrounding her while she was in the hospital. They said, "Miss Mackey, we're glad that you're up. We're glad that you're alive." And the first thing Sister Mackey said was, "Where is my husband?" They said, "Well, you're doing okay. Your vitals are good. We're just happy that you've made it out." She said again, "Where is my husband?" And the physician came to her and said, "I'm sorry, but your husband didn't make it." Patricia Ann Mackey said, "Take me to his body." So they got out of bed, and she realized that she couldn't walk. They put her in a wheelchair and rolled her to her husband's body. When she got to his body, she touched his thigh and breathed heavy and said, "Lord, he is a my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for thy name's sake. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death." Grabbed her thigh again and said, "Lord, I'm in the shadow of death right now." At this time, Patricia Ann Mackey, my Aunt Ann, was at the lowest place of her life, all because of something that happened in her life. It took her to a place of wanting to let go. It took her to a place of being in fear. It took her to a place of wanting to say, "I've had enough with my life, and I'm done right now." My brothers and my sisters, that's a sad but yet common story on today. Because I know that she isn't the only one. Maybe there's somebody in this place who is being at the back of the shadow of death. Can I get a witness in the house on tonight? Now, you may not have been in some type of car accident. You might not have seen your husband or wife's body in front of you dead right there. But I guarantee I got some folk in here who's been down and out, who's been struggling, who's been going through some mess that made it feel like they were at the back of the shadow of death. So as the case in the text, David the mighty warrior, David the man after God's own heart, David the man who was talented and who was anointed to be the king of Israel, at this time was in one of the lowest points of his life. If you're a Bible reader, you'll know that David was on run. He was running from his own boy by the name of Absalom. Maybe because he felt as though Absalom was getting a lot of attention from the Israelites. Maybe he felt though that Absalom felt like that he was better and stronger and wiser than his own dad. Maybe he thought that in any time Absalom was going to come and they was going to have a vote and kick David out as the, I wish I had somebody, kick David out as the leader and bring Absalom in to lead the children of Israel at that time. David was in distress, and David was hiding. David was in a place of fear. David was in one of the lowest points of his life. And David began to be like my Aunt Ann and said, "The Lord is my shepherd." I feel like preaching in the house on you. "I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul." David was at a low point of his life. David felt like he was the shadow of death. And at this low point of David's life, when David's back was against the wall, when David felt like there was no hope for him left, when David felt like it was the end for him, while he was in his own valley, a valley that seemed too low for David to get up from by himself, while he was down and out, all of a sudden, he went from verses 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and ended up at verse number 6. David was in a bad place in his life. David felt like there was no way he could come out as being victorious at that place. But all of a sudden, David flipped the script, and he started to think about something that changed his mindset, that changed his attitude, that changed the way he felt, and said, "Ha ha, shut up." David at the lowest point of his life at a high moment. And every now and then, that's what we need in our life. While we're down and out, while we're feeling bad for ourselves, sometimes we gotta look up and think about something. Think about a man who can save our soul. Think about a man who can deliver us from anything and everything that we go through. Think about a man that saved me yesterday, and the day before yesterday, and the day before yesterday, and the day before that, and the day before that. And look up to the sky and say, "I know I'm in a funk. I know I'm in a bad place, but I surely." Still smile, still look good, still not act like we're depressed, because we know. was down and out, he thought about that God promised him something in his life. Not only did he think about, but he had a firm understanding of God's promise too. David said, in the midst of his despair, in the midst of his bad time, in the midst of going through his pain, David said, surely. Can I tell you what the promise was? Now you better act like God could own something in his house. David said, surely. I got to get one more, in my mouth and now I get to know it. David said, surely. Here's the promise. Goodness. You are on today. As long as you're in Christ, as long as you got the Holy Ghost on the inside of you, no matter where you walk, you got goodness. You got the Lord on your side. I don't care how low it gets, God'll go low with you. I don't care how bad it gets, God'll be there with you. That's who goodness see us. David spirit on the inside of us. We got to learn how to flip the script of always feeling sorry for ourselves. I'm so sick of y'all looking like y'all stink, looking like y'all been through what y'all going through. You better have a surely moment and fix your own nappy head and put a wig on if you got to. Get in that shower. Put that cocoa butter on your back. And you get to the place where you can encourage yourself and get into God and know that if you're born again, because you're in a bad place. God promise I'll never leave you nor forsake you. God promise I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. God promise that he gonna be right there, that he ain't gonna be by himself. God's gonna bring goodness and God's gonna bring mercy.
Sister Mackie,
Yeah, you made it through this. But I hate to tell you, you ain't going to ever walk again. Oh, she was hurt. She was down and out. But if she had in that hospital, while she was in the lowest point of her life, an aha moment. And the doctor said, she looked at that doctor and began to smile with a disfigured face and said, "You don't know the God that I serve." Y'all, I'm trying to tell you, she had that plastic surgery. And my auntie came out of plastic surgery looking better than she ever had in her life. Not only did she have plastic surgery, but I come to tell you that 6 months later, my auntie was not just standing up, but she was walking around on them 2 feet that they said that she would never be able to use again. My auntie said, "Lord, since you blessed me, like I knew you was going to bless me. Every time I get into the house of the Lord, I'm going to praise and serve in your name." And my brothers and my sisters, every time my auntie got to a church house, she began to do like this. Walk around that old sanctuary, back and forth. Funeral service and doing like this, walking around that old sanctuary. My auntie would, yes, be at a wedding and walking around that sanctuary.